If you want to learn about what is AWS and what are the most commonly used AWS services, you are in the right place. Stay tuned, we are about to start. And feel free to subscribe for more amazing tutorial about AWS. So what is AWS? Amazon Web Services, aka AWS, is a cloud platform and is the world's most popular, reliable, secure, scalable, and easy-to-use cloud services available in the planet. It provides an on-demand infrastructure on a pay-as-you-go basis. With a suite of 200-plus services that include servers, database, storage, content delivery, DNS management, global region, identity access management, management tool, all are used by top companies in the world. Out of all the services provided by AWS, today I'm going to share with you the most commonly used AWS services that you should know about. Okay, so let's start with AWS EC2. AWS EC2 is one of the most used and important services offered by AWS. It allows you to launch virtual server. You can configure the hardware of those instances to fit your need and then to connect to them via the terminal. EC2 instances are used as web server, but you can in fact execute any code or application on them. Popular related services are AWS Elastic Beanstalk. It's a management tool which does all the work to create an EC2 instance, Intel application, software, and give you freedom for manual tasks in creating an environment. Another one is AWS LightSail. It's a similar but more user-friendly management option and a good for small application. And also the AWS AutoScale solution that helps you to monitor your app and automatically tune capacity to sustain steady, predictable performance at the lowest possible price. Next one on the list is Amazon RDS. It's a managed relational database in the cloud. It takes care of hardware provisioning, database setup, patching, and backup. Amazon RDS supports various database engines like Amazon Aurora, PostgreSQL, MySQL, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle Database, and Maria Database. Popular related services are AWS DynamoDB. It's a high-performance managed NoSQL database that supports both key-value and document store. Also, it's AWS Aurora. It's a MySQL and PostgreSQL compatible high-performance distributed relational database. And my favorite one is AWS ElastiCache. It's an AWS service that easily to set up, run, and scale popular open source in-memory data storage in the cloud, basically like Memcache and Redis. Next one on the list is Amazon S3 or Simple Storage Service. It's actually the service AWS originally started with, and it's an object storage service. That means it's built to store files of all kinds, image, video, text document. You could use it as your own personal cloud file storage, or you can access to it via your code running on AWS EC2 or Lambda or through one of the other services offered by AWS. Next one on the list is AWS IAM, the Identity and Access Management Service. It's probably the most important service offered by AWS. With it, you can configure access control for user of your AWS account and even the services used in there. Next one on the list became very popular recently. It's AWS Lambda. Lambda is a serverless compute service that enables you to run your code on AWS platform without worrying about provisioning, maintenance, and scaling the server. Your code gets automatically executed on incoming event or HTTP requests at any scale. Most popular languages like JavaScript, C#, Java, Go, and Python are supported, and deployment is effortless. Next one on the list is AWS SQS, one of my favorite is Simple Queue Services. With SQS, you can send, store, and receive messages between microservices and serverless applications. It's a fully managed service that has two types of messaging options. Standard queue are best for maximum throughput and at least once delivery, while FIFO guarantee that messages are processed exactly once in the exact sending order. Another amazing AWS services that is commonly used is AWS SES. Amazon Simple Email Service is a flexible email service that supports mass email communication, marketing, and transactional email at scale. It offers some analytic and calculated open and click-through rate to measure audience engagement in your email messages. Next one on the list is AWS SNS, Simple Notification Service, that is used to send notification to the user on any platform, mobile or web. It's an event-driven hub that alerts services, subscribe to it, and perform tasks automatically in response to specific trigger. Another amazing service is AWS API Gateway. It makes it easy to create, publish, monitor, and secure RESTful and WebSocket API. It handles traffic management, course authorization and access control, throttling, monitoring, and API version management. API Gateway can process hundreds of thousands of concurrent API calls. It's a fully managed service and you pay only for the API calls your application receives and the amount of outgoing traffic. Another most commonly used service is AWS CloudFront. AWS CloudFront is a global content delivery or CDN service that built for high speed, low latency performance, security, and developer easy of use. Another amazing service is AWS ELB or Elastic Load Balancing. Elastic Load Balancing distributes incoming application traffic across multiple server, container, or even Lambda function. It enables the application to handle more concurrent requests without affecting response time. If you are in love with container and Kubernetes, AWS also covers you here with AWS ECS. AWS ECS is a fully managed container orchestration service that enables you to run, scale, and secure Docker application on Amazon EC2 and AWS Fargate. You can define multiple related containers and configure their various deployment parameters in task definition. Being a fundamental pillar for critical AWS services, it can natively integrate with Route 53, Secret Manager, IAM, CloudWatch, and other AWS services. Related AWS container services is AWS Elastic Container Registry or ECR. Amazon Elastic Container Registry is a fully managed Docker container registry that makes it easy for developers to store, manage, and deploy Docker container images. Another services is Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service or AWS EKS. EKS makes it easy to deploy, manage, and scale containerized application using Kubernetes. And also AWS Fargate, that is a little bit similar to AWS EC2, but it's more serverless pay-as-you-go compute engine that lets you focus on building application without managing server. Number 13 on the list is AWS Route 53. AWS Route 53 is a highly available and scalable cloud domain name system web service. It's designed to give developers and businesses an extremely reliable and cost-effective way to route end users to internet application. If you decided to jump from container to machine learning, AWS covers you also with AWS SageMaker. AWS SageMaker is a fully managed service that abstracts away many of the complexity of machine learning process. It allows you to focus on your data and not so much on setting up the appropriate resource and model. You can instead choose from a set of predefined services, prepare your data, and set up how to apply the algorithm on it, and then create and test your model. Once an optimized model is found, you can easily also directly deploy it into production. AWS also offers AI services that is predefined and ready for you for production. One of them is AWS Lex. It's an AI framework that helps you build, configure, and deploy chat-based applications very quickly. Another popular service is AWS Polly. It's an AI service that turns any text into lifelike speech, allowing you to create applications that talk. And also AWS Rekognition, it's a service that can identify object, people, text, scene, and even activity. And the last one for today is AWS CloudWatch. AWS CloudWatch provides a unified view of AWS resources and services of your application. It's helpful to optimize resources, detect abnormal behavior, set different alarms, monitor application health, and troubleshoot issues by viewing log and various metrics. That is all for today. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe and also leave a comment below if you have any question regarding AWS and how to learn more about AWS services.